Hello friends, here in this video we will see the definition of power screw with various thread profiles which are there in case of power screws. So let us get started. Here is the definition part of power screws. Now, as the name suggests, it is power screws, means screw which have some power. So here I'll write it down that power screws are screws which either receive power or which transmit power. So this is the simplest definition of power screws, that they are the screws which either receive power or which transmit power. Now I can say that from this it is very much clear that power screws are different in design than screw fasteners. Screw fasteners are nothing but those are the screws which are used as a temporary joint. Like if we have two screws, then we are using them as a temporary joint. That is called as a screw fastener. But power screws, since they are transmitting power, their design is different from that of screw fasteners. Next, they must have sufficient strength to transmit power. Here it means that power screws, they should be strong enough to transfer the power, because they are mostly used in case of machines where the power transmission is of prime importance. So the screw, they must have sufficient strength. Next, they should have adequate bearing area to withstand forces. Means the power screws, their area should be such that they should be able to resist high amount of forces, because they are used in such machineries where always these screws, they would be subjected to some kind of axial movement in the horizontal direction or vertical direction. So always there are forces acting on such kind of screws. So this is the definition part. Now I will draw some of the commonly used thread profiles in power screws. Thread profiles of power screws. Now, when I am starting from the thread profile, the most commonly used thread profile which we have, it is a square threaded screw. Here the profile is in such a way that it forms a square. So I am taking just this section. Now, if I draw the section here, this is the thread profile which has square threads, and it will look something like this. Now, this is the profile, the first one. I'll say that it is the profile of square threads. Now, square threads are mostly used for power transmission, and if I want to indicate some of the common distances, if I take any point on this thread and along its axis, if I measure the distance on the next thread for the same point, this distance would be called as pitch. And now here I have this as the height of thread denoted by H, and this top surface of the thread is taken as half of pitch, that is pitch by 2. So now this is regarding the square thread. After this, the second most commonly used profile is of Acme threads. Here I am drawing the profile of Acme threads. This is the cut section, and here I'll draw the section lines. Now, these are Acme threads. Now, again, in case of Acme threads, I can show the pitch. If I measure the distance, that is, I take a point on a thread, on the next thread, if I take the point at the same location and measure this distance, it would be called as the pitch. And this pitch will remain same throughout, denoted by small p. Next, this top surface of the thread, it is taken as 0.37 times of pitch. Now, as we can see from the diagram, compared to square thread, square thread was having 90 degree angle like this, it was inclined at 90 degree, but here in case of Acme threads, they are inclined at some other angle. If I extend these lines, so they are at an angle. Now this angle is called as 2 beta, that is the angle between the thread flanks. Acme threads, as I can see here, that at the bottom, your area is more. So this offers additional strength to Acme threads compared to square threads. Next, the third type of thread profile which we have, it is called as buttress thread. Here I am drawing the thread profile for it. This is buttress thread profile, mostly used in machine vices. Here I am drawing the section for the buttress thread. Now, this is the profile of buttress thread. So now, here the thread profile which I have drawn, it is called as buttress thread. Now, in case of buttress thread, again, as I have shown the pitch for square and Acme threads, similarly here we are having the pitch for buttress thread, and this top surface, it is taken approximately equal to 0.125 times of pitch, and here is the height of thread. And this angle, as I extend this vertical line and this inclined line, they will meet at an angle which is inclined at 45 degrees. So that is the inclination which we are taking for buttress thread. Now, as we can see, for buttress thread also, the area at the bottom, that is called as the core of the thread. So at the core, the area is more. So this offers more strength for the thread. And buttress thread, it is useful for power transmission. I'll write it down. It is for power transmission in both the directions. That is, if we are using buttress thread, with the help of that we can transfer the power in forward direction as well as we can transfer the power in the reverse direction. So mostly buttress threads, they are used in case of machine vices, the where we are clamping the workpiece, that is in case of a clamp we are attaching this buttress thread to the machine table, and then when we are rotating the handle, with the help of that this thread moves forward or backward. So when it is moving forward or backward, it has adequate strength to transfer the motion. And mostly, as I have told, it is used in case of clamps or in case of machine vices. Square threaded screw, they are used in case of screw jack, in case of universal testing machine, and even in case of lathe machine. As I talk about Acme threads, they are preferably used in case of lathe machine, where we are having the lead screw of the lathe which is continuously rotating and transferring the carriage from one place to another. There we are having Acme threads to transfer the motion. So in this video we have seen the definition of power screws and the various thread profiles available for power screws.